Yamaha's MTX Series Matrix Processors. What are they? And what can they do for your audio installation and your business? The following videos will give you an overview of the product's range, including an introduction to the hardware, the additional options, as well as a guide to the simple editing software for the MTX Series. To start with, many people ask, what exactly are the MTX processors? Well, in simple terms, they are a digital mixer inside a metal box, but without the faders. Why no faders? Well, because they're designed to be controlled by non-audio professionals, hoteliers, teachers, bar staff, or preachers, and they offer simple, non-technical control of sophisticated audio systems. Let's give an example in the next video. Imagine we have an MTX installed in a lecture hall. We have a number of microphones and a background music player all plugged into the MTX. Inside the MTX are all the elements required to mix and process the sound, and typically all of them are programmed by an installation company or systems integrator. These processors include EQ, feedback suppressors, Dandugan auto mixer and speaker processors, etc. And we'll take a closer look at this processing in a moment. Once the input and output processing is complete, the audio is then fed to an amplifier, such as the multi-channel Yamaha XMV, and then delivered to various speaker zones in the auditorium. The organizers are not audio technicians, so they want simple control of certain functions that have been pre-programmed by the installer. And there's a wide range of simple remote control options that can be used. These include simple wall panels with labeled knobs and buttons, or more sophisticated digital wall panels. There's a free wireless version that can be operated by iOS or Android phone or tablet, and a free iPad app called Provisionaire Touch. Or we can use touchscreen controllers by other manufacturers such as Crestron, or for more advanced control, they can be operated locally by a PC. And for very simple applications, they can be controlled using a general purpose interface or a GPI switch. The ability to offer the customer simple remote control is the reason why so many retail environments, for example, such as these, favor the MTX series as the heart of their audio system. If the customer wants to keep human control completely out of the equation, then the MTX series can be programmed to automatically change functions according to the time and date on a calendar, using something called the scheduler function. Now that we've understood what the MTX series processors are, let's take a closer look at the hardware. Looking at the specifications, both MTX3 and MTX5D have 8 mic line inputs, 8 channels of analog outputs, and 16 channels of WiDIF, which I'll explain later, as well as the ability to play audio from an inserted SD card. In addition to this, the MTX5D has a larger matrix mixer, 16 channels of Dante I/O, and a slot to insert something called an MY card, which is used for additional inputs, outputs, or processing. Looking at the back panel of the processors, we can see that both have 8 channels of mic line inputs and outputs on the green Euroblock connectors, plus 2 stereo inputs on RCA or phono connectors. There are the WiDIF input and output connectors, which I'll explain shortly, and then on the MTX-5D, there's the additional card slot for a large selection of optional inputs and outputs, plus the Dante connection ports. The WiDIF interface on the rear panel of the MTX series is for Yamaha's proprietary network that loops up to 16 channels to and from devices using Cat5e cable up to a distance of 30 meters. The most common application of WiDIF is to link MTX processors with amplifiers in the audio system or to route audio from input or output expanders that we'll take a look at shortly. Providing no unit is more than 30 meters away, whole systems can be linked via WiDIF, including inputs, processing, outputs, and amplifiers. This is a big cost saving in cable and installation hours. If the system spans over 30 meters, then the MTX-5D can take advantage of its Dante network ports, which facilitate the interconnection of devices up to 100 meters apart. MTX-5D can transmit up to 16 channels of audio over Dante. And for greater channel count, please consider the MTX's larger brother, the MRX 7D. Yamaha provides a range of DCP hardware remote control panels that are available in both EU and US mounting options. up to 8 DCPs can be connected to and control a single MTX processor. They connect either in series or in a combination of star and series configuration using the optional DCH8 digital controller hub. Everything is provided to maximize the flexibility of your installation. Furthermore, up to 16 units of the more advanced MCP1 wall mount controller can be connected to an MTX processor, and these can be provided with power over Ethernet by one of Yamaha's series of SWR2100P power over Ethernet switches. The same switch can provide power for Yamaha's paging station solution called the PGM1. Four PGM1s can be connected to an MTX, along with two PGX1 expanders per PGM1. All this additional hardware can create very sophisticated and flexible audio solutions. That is an overview of the MTX series hardware. In the next video, we'll take a look at the software used to edit the processors, as well as the range of specialist processing available.